Joining us right now, a first-of-its-kind education summit is underway. Hello, I'm Jessica Miles.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Vanita Sakar. State education leaders are gathering all day long to work at reducing barriers facing American Indian students. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Naomi Peskovitz is live in St. Paul. And Naomi, the big issue they want to focus on is the achievement gap.
Well, that's right, Jessica and Vanita. Educators here are extremely hopeful. They say they've been waiting for this for a long time. And for some of them, this process is overdue. For an achievement gap that's lasted decades, there is no easy fix.
We have an educational system that continues to fail Native people big time.
The latest standardized tests in the state show 78% of white third graders performing at adequate levels in math. That's compared to 48% of American Indian students.
The gaps are in student engagement, parent engagement. We have kids that come in with incredibly low reading scores, language skills, lack of sense of belonging.
I think they're struggling most in just coming to school.
It's an achievement gap that goes beyond grade school. David Isham with the State College and University System says recruiting isn't the problem.
Once they're there, these institutions, they still struggle with meeting the needs.
So the focus now is on change as this summit looks to ways they can make all classrooms better places to learn.
Really ask the hard questions and come up with the real answers. What's missing? What are we not doing right? What are we doing well? Great. What can we do better?
And some of the educators here today tell me that one of the best solutions is just having the voices of American Indians at the table. Today, that is happening. We also heard from the state superintendent for Montana. There, some policies have already worked. Reporting live in St. Paul, Naomi Peskovitz, 5 Eyewitness News.